themselves. We seek neither military superiority nor political advantage. Our only purpose, one all people share, is to search for ways to reduce the danger of nuclear war. My fellow Americans, tonight we're launching an effort which holds the promise of changing the course of human history. There will be risks, and results take time, but I believe we can do it. As we cross this threshold, I ask for your prayers and your support. Thank you. Good night, and God bless you.
Remarks by President Reagan to Rockwell International, Lockheed, and Northrop employees. Hangar 703,
testing
Rockwell
1-2.
Production flight test installation,
audio test, 1-2.
Palmdale, California, 22
test,
October 1984.
Test.
Open press coverage.
Raise your hand, Bob. Assemblywoman Kathy Wright, California Assembly. Assemblywoman Marion La Follette, California Assembly. U.S. Representative. Okay.
Ladies and gentlemen, the President of the United States and Mr. Bob Anderson, Chairman of Rockwell International.
But for the sake of our children, for the sake of the future of this country of ours, we must send them back to Washington for 4 more years. Ladies and gentlemen, the President of the United States, Ronald Reagan.
Thank you. Thank you all very much. Thank you all very much. Governor Duke Majan, Senator Pete Wilson, our congressman here, and one who must be a congressman and join them in Washington, Bob Dornan, along with Carlos Moorhead and Bill Thomas, and the members of your state legislature, your county government, your local officials, and all of you, ladies and gentlemen. Being here among friends and with professionals of Rockwell, Lockheed, and Northrop, and feeling your home state pride reminds us once again of America's renewed spirit. We're entering the home stretch of the campaign. Or didn't you know that? We've set our sights on victory, and I believe the election of 1984 will be a victory for us all, for the future over the past, for progress over failure, for hope over despair, and yes, for strength over weakness. And what an airplane. You know, I have no complaints about Air Force One, but I was wondering, does Rockwell take trade-ins? Let me congratulate Sam Nicobellis, the men and women of Rockwell, the subcontractors around the country, and the whole aerospace industry. You are doing a magnificent job. And I know there could be no better group of people working together than you, the men and women of our aerospace team here in Southern California. The teamwork of the B-1B is something to behold. 5,200 suppliers and subcontractors, 55,000 workers nationwide with 17,000 workers right here in California, producing quality work ahead of schedule and under cost. Never. Now, present company accepted, have you ever stood on our side? Yours is the work of peace. The B-1B strategic bomber, two-thirds the size of the aging B-52 with twice the payload, and I've learned since I've been here, I was wrong about that. It's 2.5 times the payload. With 1/100th of the radar cross-section and with the most advanced electronic defense system in the world, will keep America prepared for peace. You know, those people who criticize and somehow think that in defending ourselves or having the weapons of defense that somehow that makes us warlike, I don't know whether you know this, but up at Fairchild Air Base, where I'm going up in the state of Washington, there's a sign over the gate that says, "Peace is our profession." Well, I'm delighted that just last week, the first production model successfully completed its initial flight. The readiness, the capability, and resolve of our armed forces are the greatest guarantees we have that our young people will never again see the ugly face of war. There have been four wars in my lifetime. None of them started because America was too strong. Earlier this year on Memorial Day, America laid to rest so foreign to what the leadership of the Democratic Party once believed. Well, join us in a bipartisan way, we'll make this country the way it should be. Thank you very much. God bless you.
Mr. President, on behalf of all of the aerospace workers from Lockheed and from Northrop and from Rockwell and from all companies who are represented here today, we want to tell you how much we appreciate you taking time out of your schedule to pay us a visit. I'd like to also say that I think the aerospace men and women represented here today are the finest in the world and represent truly a valuable national asset. Your visit here today comes just 36 months after you made a commitment to the American people to rebuild our strategic deterrent force. And I think, as you look around you, we've come a long ways in 36 months. It's also a significant date to those of us who have been associated with the B-1 for a long time, because we were very shocked when the Carter-Mondale administration canceled this important program to our national defense. And yes, Mr. President, all of us here know where Mondale stands on this program. Last week, the first B-1B production aircraft took off on this runway on a very successful first test flight. Number two is right behind it. And all of our people are charged up and working hard to complete this program for this nation. It's an outstanding example of what government and industry can accomplish in a short period of time with the can-do spirit of cooperation that we've all had on this program. And so now, speaking for all of the B-1B employees working with their dedicated skills on this program right across the nation from 5,200 companies, I'd like to present in their honor to the President a model of the B-1B long-range combat aircraft. Ladies and gentlemen, that concludes the meeting. The President, as I understand, off from here to San Diego. Thank you all for joining us. We appreciate it.